Now we're to the top side of the tote again. I'm going to take the liner, pull it out from underneath the top bar. I'm going to pull it back so that you can look inside and see that the liner is flat along the front side of the tank. That would be the first indication if you have twisted the liner in the discharge opening, is that the whole liner would be twisted. But this one's nice and flat along the front. We're going to pick it up, lower it down into the tote, open it up, and you'll see an arrow on the bib. That always points to the front. And I'm going to take this and stretch it over the 6-inch opening. Now, this is a tight fit. It's designed to be that way. But it fits in there pretty much like an elastic band. Stretch it around the top opening. Then you'll see the vacuum, what we call is a vacuum spout. This is the spout that gives our Venturi valve access to the backside of the liner, to the air that needs to be pulled out of the tank. So I'm going to take the Venturi valve and slip it in the opening and push it all the way through to the backside so that it gets access to the air behind the tank. Push it through to the backside, then I'll start to pull the air out of the tank. It's a little loud, so I'll speak up. But as I'm doing that, we're going to show you with the camera, you can look straight down inside and see the liner expanding inside the tank. What's happening is that the air is being evacuated from the tank, the liner is being pulled into the sidewalls of the tank. Now as it gets towards the end, I'm going to slow it down on the Venturi valve. It's real important that the tote that you're working with is not only clean, but it's dry. Because as I'm slowing it down, that liner's sliding along the edge of the tank. But if it was wet or if it was sticky, the liner would not want to move into the corners of the tank. Now, the first step of the inflation is done. I'm going to pull the Venturi valve out, and we're going to look down inside, and you'll see that the liner's substantially against the wall of the tank, but there's still quite a few wrinkles on the bottom. To eliminate those wrinkles, we're going to pick the liner up off the opening, squeeze it so that now I have like a balloon inside the tank. I'm going to push down straight inside. And when I do, I'm going to rock it, rock the liner side to side, front to back, and that's stretching the liner across the bottom of the tote, pulling the wrinkles out of the liner, putting it back over the top, stretching it into place, and then I've got to do a quick vacuum to get the liner open. To take the rest of the air out that was between, that I let back in as I was pulling that out. I won't pull it very hard or very fast. But you can see as the liner begins to expand and stretch into place, I'm going to pull it to the side, and you can look right down inside, and you can see that the liner is against the bottom of the tank, and that the opening is open. That's an important check to make sure that nothing will disturb the liner, disturb the product from being discharged from the tank. While the Venturi valve is still running, I'm going to slide the Venturi valve out of the vent spout, shut it off, and tie an end in the end of the spout to prevent any of the air from leaking in back behind the liner. And at that point, the liner is ready to fill. That completes the demonstration of the installation of a liner inside a 275-gallon Greif tote. If there are any further questions or to place an order, please call 518-584-0441. Thank you.